Yeah. Okay, thanks. So thanks for the opportunity. Myself, Sathish Kumar, Thiyagarajan. It's about, I have been into this IT industry for around 16 years. I always think about what makes a great product. Any guess? A clue is this talk is about UX.
Speed.
Okay. Yeah. Matters. Okay. So many places that I see, people consider it is skill or technology that makes great product. Even I was thinking so, but my experience when I see some people where they use legacy technology, teams are slower, but still they make quality products, which is used by so many people. In fact, one lesson that I learned just a few years before this, one of the largest online grocery store in the world, even today it runs on a technology called servlet, which is age older actually. But still they make things work. So there is something that is missing that is between a great product and how we usually do. So that's my search. I always research through that. I find multiple items. One of that item is what I'm going to talk about today. So this talk is about UX matters. So when we talk about UX, there are people, it's either people really, really consider UX very seriously or people consider what UX, okay. There will be always two teams where they say, okay, development team, they work, and the other team, they design. So design and work are not considered as a same thing, strangely. So we will see for whom UX matters, for whom UX doesn't matter. So that's the idea. Okay, so it's story time. I'm very much related to story time. The reason being, apart from softwares, I'm interested in three things: softwares, agriculture, and filmmaking. I make filmmaking, and whenever I work with UX, I relate myself doing films because it's an artistic work and it is related to UX in some sense. So that's how I come into UX. So it's a story time. I'm going to tell you multiple stories. So I come from India, where we have a pattern of movie. Where our stories will be something like, there will be multiple stories and they have a common thread. Finally, we will give a socially relevant topic. That's how we want to structure our films in our industry. So I will also follow that. So what are stories that I'm going to tell? It's based on real stories. In some places I will put the name, some places I will hide the name for safety reasons. So now, this is the general picture of an organization. So usually these are all the people who work towards a product. So we all love our product. We all work for our product. We all want our product to be successful. So who all are there? It's management. Management always thinks about profits. And the product owners, they think about use cases and all those stuff. Performance engineer, performance designers, they think about visual design. Developers, they always want to write less code. Managers, they worry about delivery. So in this, who are directly related to UX, the direct answer will be like, okay, design is done by visual designer, they work on UX, and for whom you are doing UX is for user. So there are two things that we need to note here. Who works on UX, it's visual designer. For whom we do UX is for the user. So this is the broad assumption that we have. My experience taught me something different, that's what I'm going to explain today. So I'm going to start with a first story. So this story happened around 10 years before, once ATMs were there in mainline. In India, ATMs are very, very important because of the population. There will be long queues. A bank decided they want to make their ATMs faster. And they did a lot of research, and then they made their ATMs faster by 40%. 40% is not a small amount, because 40% is more, means 40% more people that you can serve. So how did they do it? In fact, when this news came up, this came in multiple newspapers, there will be a lot of advertisements and all those stuff. Even I was thinking as an engineer, okay, how many new servers that they have added? How many new ATM machines that they have put? Any clues how did they achieve 40% better ATMs? Any clues? Okay, so rather, it's not an imaginary story. You can go to Google and you can see HDFC ATMs are 100%, 40% faster, and this is how they made it. 40% faster. Nowadays in the ATMs that you see, you will have a favorite amount. Earlier I used to type, if I want to take say $2,000, 2000. Rather, if I take 2000 again and again, some usability engineers did a research and find out that a person most often takes a constant amount often. So in that case, I don't need to type multiple things. I can type my favorite number and then I can go. So this is not just a small amount, right? This is a huge profit that people save. Not with any engineers, great infrastructure and all those. It's just simple usability. And In fact, when I think about this, sometimes I get frustrated why people don't think usability as an important stuff sometimes. So, okay. Okay, so in this story, so the beneficiary of switching to okay, can you connect me to Wi-Fi? Mm-hmm. Wi-Fi.
Oh, did the internet just die? Excellent. Let's try this. Do.
So who is the benefit, who got benefited out of this is management. So then there is another story. We did a product for, you see these touch points in malls where we go and know about what is there, what is available in that particular mall. So we had a customer, he's a major car maker, car manufacturer. He wanted to make an infoinment kind of a screen where users can come and then they can model their own car. That is the use case. And this project came to us when we were working in a service company, and the timeline was just 6 weeks. We wanted to do a prototype, and 2 weeks are gone by the time that I joined, and the project was going nowhere. The client was about to drop the product. What happened is, we had a proper BA, we had a proper development team, they were working day and night, we had a proper designer, we had a proper manager, everybody was there, but the product was going nowhere. And what happened is, once we got into the product and observed this BA gave lot of requirement documents to the client, and the client said, okay, fine, and then they implemented it. At the end, the client said, okay, no, this is not what I want something else. And this keeps repeating. And for a project which is of like a smaller timeline, it's very difficult. And there was only 4 weeks that was remaining in that product. So we need to complete it quickly. So what we did is, we stopped all the developers, all the BAs to work, and we just took a visual designer, we sit with him, and then we make an usability flow where it says, okay, it just set up 9 images sequence with 0001 like that, so that it's sequential, and then we made some 9 images, and then saying user gets into it, he clicks this, so it's kind of an usability flow, and we shared it with the client, and then client said, exactly, this is what we want. And by the time we gave it to the developer, they know what exactly they want to do. So that's a clarity that they gave. So the product got delivered ultimately in 2 weeks. So in this case, the benefit that we observed is, a developer, earlier he was doing day and night of work, but actually all that he needed was just less amount of code. And then from the manager side, the delivery was way ahead of the time. That's the benefit. But the point that I want to note here is, it's the clarity that UX developers bring in. This is the aspect that many people do not consider seriously. It is not just nice looking UI, user-centric design and all those stuff. It's the clarity that we bring into the developers, we bring into the BA, we bring into the customer, all these stakeholders. That's why I think UX is important. It's much more than just a visual designer. In this, I know there is one strange case, that is performance engineer. But before performance engineer, what is my next case? Okay, so next case is about few years before, I had this wonderful opportunity to work with some doctorate people. They all are PhD from some of the most popular universities. So they came up with an idea where they said, okay, we want to create a next generation of chatbot. Even now, machine learning is Latin and Greek to me. I don't understand anything. And 4 years before, it was even bad. So I couldn't understand anything. But at the end of the day, we just sat with him. And then we just want to understand this. The reason that they came to us is, engineering-wise, they are very solid. But they want to take it to people who are not engineering talented people. They want to take it to the layman. So they need to add simplicity to their product. That's why they came into us. So what we did is, we did an usability research. In fact, we took a case study on Firebase. Even though it's a chatbot, our backend was not ready. What we did is, we simulated the entire chatbot using Firebase, and then we show them that this is how you want to create your product, and then later they said, exactly, this is what we want to build, and that's how we actually created the product. In fact, that product is already live. It's 2 years, so I think they will make it big. I can't reveal the name. So here product owner. So identifying use case itself sometimes UX is a great tool. And the strangest of all, which was quite surprising to me, is this. So I work with an airline system, airline booking system, where we had this performance issue. A performance issue is something that you will talk about developers, you talk about architecture and all this stuff. But our performance issue is this. We had a case where during a particular period of booking, we need to do a lot of reconciliation. We need to get pull data from multiple sources, do some analytics, and then make some calculations. Even if you do a better machine that we had at that point in time, it takes 2 minutes. And our user was frustrated. He was saying, okay, 2 minutes is so much of time. And they are not ready to increase their server or whatever it is. We had a limited budget. And that time, we went to a UX designer and he gave a suggestion. Any clue how we solve this performance issue? Okay, so it was during the booking, you see widgets, 1, 2, 3. First you will enter the names, second, in fact, that's a technique that we use. The reason being, if you directly allow people to go to booking, there will be 100 people sitting in the booking, but rather you ask the user, enter your name first. Then you ask the user, enter your bank detail. By the time he completes the second one, we can easily predict he's going to what is next set of action. So we can do that much earlier than the user comes. By the time user comes, we'll keep everything ready, we'll give it immediately. So user thinks as if our system is highly performance, but actually the performance is just a gimmick, it's just a magic. And this is what an UX can bring into a good product. And that's how a performance engineer comes. Okay. So bottom line is, anybody who works a product, think about usability, because it's usability that takes your product to the user actually. Now, I just want to see one common thread between all these great products. So what Microsoft did to desktop, or what Apple did to phones, what Google did to search, but the last two are interesting case studies. So rather I will take the last two. Because I know quite a few graduates from colleges, some great colleges, they talk to me something like this. Okay, we are doing messaging for quite some time. Okay, we are doing location-based service for quite some time. But what WhatsApp or Uber did is they took the technology, made it usable to the larger audience. And it is the usability that made the difference between these companies, these products, compared to others. So now this is what I learned actually. What makes a great product? Actually, what I learned over the period of time is your product and your UX are not two different things. It's one and same. If that mindset is there, and with that mindset we think, if we love our product, if you look at that group, everybody love their products. If they are serious about the product, then I think they should be serious about UX also. Okay, so now, okay, we came to the question and we found the answer. Is that the end of session? No, there is something that is interesting. People talk about this, but I don't think many people believe in this. I'll show you one strange fact. When we talk about this, people don't trust, but then there is some authorized source, so people might trust. Top 10 skills in IT industry is, in 2015, the place for creativity is always a skill, but at what level? So it was at the 10th place, and then now people are saying it's a third place. Creativity is a great skill today in 2020. And also, can anybody guess why is it so? Why creativity is a much bigger skill today than yesterday? Okay, so over the period of time, if you look at it, the technology becomes simpler and simpler, simpler. So I just want to highlight three generations. The first generation, where we install everything in a bare metal, we need to carry our machines, all this. That is the time that software was a little difficult, and that's why you see only big names, Oracle, IBM, SAP, all those people were ruling systems like ERP, large volume softwares. So there was always a segregation between large companies, smaller companies. Now, if you look at today's trend, the threat for larger companies are not yet another larger company. It is a smaller companies which are disruptive technologies. So why those things are possible is because innovations like cloud and all those stuff, which makes technology accessible even to some, say, poor companies. Okay. But now it's a third generation where it is not just companies, it's the user who has access to the technology. Why I say user who has, in fact, it was a surprising find for me also. I'll put one case study, which myself, I was shocked actually to know that. So now, when I say technology is given to the user, why? Platforms like Firebase, Shopify, all this, if you look at it, there is a common thread. first case, first user case, I can put the name also because it's my friend. It's my music director's website. It's arza.com. It's a small music shop. He has no budget. He's an individual. And he wants to sell his pianos online. And that's how he ended up coming to us. So what we told him is, OK, earlier we thought, OK, we'll get an AWS cloud, four software engineers. It was very difficult for us. Then we came to Shopify. And in Shopify, what it gives you API marketplace for e-commerce website. You can buy APIs. You can make products out of the API. And at the end, we didn't even have that many developers also. What happened is, that guy developed a site on his phone. The site that you see now, it's live and people buy products from here. It was entirely developed by a music composer. He developed it within 2-3 days. So he just took some templates, integrated the APIs, and then he did. There he goes. Okay. So what happened is, the technology becomes simpler and simpler. So if you just stay and observe what is happening in all the industry, for example, what open banking does, or what API Commons or API Marketplaces does, they take these functionalities as APIs and they give it to you. And it's up to your creativity to use the APIs. All that you need to understand now is not the technology, it's just the APIs. If you understand the APIs, if you understand the platform, you can make things on your own. So in general, these are all the challenges that UX people face. That's what I felt. I'll put some of my views also on that challenges. What is this?
Which one is that?
Toggle button. OK. So this is a toggle button. This you will see in many of the things. But someone says, OK, something terribly wrong in this. This toggle button is not correct. What is wrong with this toggle button? This is the proper toggle button. This is not the proper toggle button. Now, can anybody guess what is really wrong in this?
I'm not sure what is selected.
So the UX expert says inverted color scheme. In the first one, the only clue is your background color is a single clue. It's difficult for the user to understand. But rather in the direct color scheme, light shading is there, bold text label is there, a darker border is there, lighter border is there. So there are multiple cues. When we say this, the first question that we'll get from the developers or an architect is, what is cue? Usually these UX things are hard to explain. And that is why many of the UX designers, they won't be able to get their creativity cut across into the product. And then it's also important your front-end architecture is simpler and it's flexible and allows experiments. Something like A-B testing, blue-green deployment, all these things. If your front-end architecture is solid, your feedback, your experiments can be done quite easily. And the last one is feedback accuracy. Even customers, sometimes they don't give proper requirements. Even though there are some great tools cannot help you in that area. That's one thing that I feel. So finally, so to come to the actual topic and then what is my vision is. So for whom usability matters? If you are into a product and you think about simplicity, if you think about clarity, if you think about profitability, then UX matters. For everybody else, it is optional. Thanks.